Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi video. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Well, we're taking a look at the great new plugin Divi Plus today, and we're going to make this 3D cube flip box really easy to do. Now, Divi Plus has just been featured in the Elegant Themes Divi library, and you can download it from here. I'll put the link below the video. It's a great addition. So let's get started. I'm going to enable the Visual Builder. And let's create a new module. I've got a section here, the blue tab. Inside the section, there's a row with two columns. You can make it any way you wish. And I'm going to add a new module with the dark button here. Divi comes with all the gray ones as standard, the gray modules there. When you add Divi Plus, you're going to get all these ones that say DP in front of them. And there's plenty of them. And we're looking for the flip box today. There it is right there. Okay, let's move this over so we can see what's going on. Now you can choose to have it flip, or you can choose to have it 3D cube, which is what I'm going to use today. Choose the direction that it wants to flip, from the top, bottom, left or right. I'm going to leave mine on the top today. Flip speed, you can slow it down or speed it up here. Same as any other Divi module, slide or type in a value, and you can fine tune with the little buttons right there. Okay, well, let's put some content in. Give it your title. I'll add a bit of content. I've got some lorem ipsum dummy text up here. As you can see, it's put it in and it's flipping already when we hover over it. Okay, down below, actually before I go down below, I'll show you, you can put the back content in here as well. Just hit the other tab for flipbox content. You can put the back. Title and content in right here. I'll put the same content in. For convenience. Then if we move down to flipbox elements, front elements, use the icon on front. Yeah, I think I'll use an icon. You don't have to, but I will. Choose whatever icon you want. And these are Elegant Themes icon. There's plenty to choose from here. Just put in whatever works for you. As we're going down, I think I'll sort of put a little down arrow in. And for the back, I don't think I'll use an icon. You can put images in like anything else. If you want to add a little image in there as well as the content, there's the back end stuff there. You can add an image if you want to. I'm going to leave mine just like that. You can display a button on the back. I think I will have a button. Whatever you want your button to say there. And of course, the URL you want your button to go to right there. If you're linking to your own site for best practice, leave it in the same window. If you're linking to an external site, somebody else's website, open it in a new tab so that your site stays open. Okay, next up, we've got the flipbox background. We've got front and back. Okay, for the front, I'm going to put in a color and an image. As you can see, it's got the image in there. And as with most Divi modules, you can blend it so that your text stands out. We'll be styling that text separately in a minute. But if you look down below, you've got the image size, cover, which is what we want. I don't want it to repeat. Position, no repeat. And image blend. Here you can actually blend it with that background color that we put in. I'm going to leave mine just like that. We put a blue in it, sort of blended it. When I color that text, it'll make it easier to read. Okay, let's move back up and let's have a look at the back. Again, let's put a color and an image in. We'll use this one. And again, we'll blend the back. To see it, you just need to flip over it. See what Multiply looks like. That's fine. And as you can see, the buttons in there also. Okay, if you want to link the module when they click on it to somewhere, put it in here. Same deal with the target. I'm not going to link mine today. Background, don't need that, it's covering it. Don't need an admin enable, I know what it is. Okay, I'm moving on to the design tab. Got front image icon style. Oh yeah, I want it at the top, as you can see it's at the top there. I want to make it white though. You can use font size to make it bigger or smaller. They've got an extra style button here, which is quite nice. You flip it to on. You can give it a background, square, circle, hexagon if you want. And you can give it a border also if you want to. I make my border white also. That's a nice little feature right there. Okay, let's have a look down below, back image and icon. Well, we haven't got an image or an icon on the back, so I can actually skip this one. Here are our text styles. Front text style, I'm going to put it all in the middle where it is at the moment. Title, really don't want to do too much to this. I'll make it bold, or semi-bold will do. Uppercase, let's make it white so we can actually see it. There we go. And let's slide it up a little bit in size. There we go. If we go back up, here's our content. All I'm going to do for the content to make it readable is make it white. Great, fantastic. So I'm happy with the front side there. Let's go on down and we can do the back text style now. And again, I'll make the title bigger and white and the content so we can see it. Well, I think I'll have this left aligned today. So in the general, I'm going to left align it. Title. Make it semi-bold, capital, white. And we'll take it up in size a little bit too. There we go. And if we roll back up to the text, or the content, I should say, all I'm going to do to that is make it white. Okay, going on down. Here's our back button style. It's not too bad, but I want to align it to the left. I'm just going to change it to white. Obviously, styling is entirely up to you. Use custom styles for button. And all I'm going to do is change button text to white there. And I want to align it on the left-hand side. There we go. Fantastic. The only other thing I want to do is perhaps give it a little more space on the bottom. I'm happy with left, right and top. So let's continue going down. And we'll go down to spacing. And on the bottom, I'm just going to give it some padding. Common to most DV modules, just give it the number. It'll put in the pixels for you. If you want to do the opposite side, just hit the chain. It'll do it. But I just want it on the bottom there. I think that's going to work fine. Just in the front and back, I'm going to add just a little bit of box shadow to lift it off the page. So I've gone into front. And as you can see, that's added a little bit of box shadow just to lift it off the page. And if we go into the back and do similar, I think we'll be done. There we go. Let's save our changes. Just hover over. There we go. Let's just check it on the front end. So I'm going to save my changes, little purple button down here. Save the changes. And let's exit the Visual Builder. And let's go down, and there's our little flip box. Nice little 3D cube there, and that's a great little feature to have on your site. Really easy to do. And like I mentioned earlier, we're using the great Divi Plus. It's a premium plugin, and like I say, I'll put the link below the video. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.